Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by MakerDemi. This is Naveen and I'm part of the instructor team at MakerDemi. In this episode, we will get to know about the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect board. Many popular microcontrollers are available for hobbyists and students in the market, ranging from the humble Atmega 328 based Arduino Uno or the 8051 to the more feature-packed ones like the expressive offerings, the ESP8266 and the ESP32. These newer offerings offer a lot more features than the Uno boards like Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and even multi-core capabilities. But technology doesn't remain stagnant and thus even better boards are to come. Enter the RP2040 chip, designed by Raspberry Pi. This new chip is miles ahead of the current popular hobbyist boards while keeping the same price. The RP2040 chip was introduced with the Raspberry Pi Pico, the company's first microcontroller board. However, this board has a major shortcoming. It does not have any wireless capabilities in terms of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth. Here comes the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect to fill the gaps. As we were introduced earlier, the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect is based on the Raspberry Pi RP2040 microcontroller. This chip was introduced to the market in January of 2021 along with the Raspberry Pi Pico board itself. The RP2040 is based on the 32-bit ARM Cortex-M0+ architecture. There are two cores present, each running at 133 MHz. This chip is pretty fast compared to the Atmega 328P, which runs at a meager 16 MHz and only has a single core. The main feature which sets this board apart from the Pico is its wireless capabilities. But there are more features than that, most of which will be discussed in this video. We are moving on to the hardware details of the board. This board has a total of 30 pins, 15 on each side. 20 of them are general purpose input-output pins. There are 14 digital pins and 6 analog pins. Other pins include VIN, +5V, +3.3V, GND and reset. Included in the GPIO are the I2C pins, the SPI pins, the UART pins. The analog pins A6 and A7, however, are not directly connected to the RP2040 but via the multi-radio module. So some functionalities on those pins are not present compared to the other input-output pins. Apart from the RP2040 itself, a lot is going on the board. U-Block's Nina W102 multi-radio module. This chip handles both 802.11b/d/n Wi-Fi and Bluetooth 4.2 for the RP2040 since it does not contain any wireless communication hardware. 16MB flash memory. Since the RP2040 does not have its own flash memory, an external solution is provided on the board itself. The large space allows developers to code at ease and not skip features when developing for the board. 6-axis IMU unit. The board comes with a 6-axis IMU, also known as inertial measurement unit. It consists of a 3D gyroscope and a 3D accelerometer, which keeps track of the spatial position and orientation of the board. The IMU unit is intelligent, so a lot of processing can be offloaded to it rather than doing it on the main MCU. Microchip ATE CC608A cryptographic coprocessor. This coprocessor helps in the security side of things. It can securely store keys and assist in cryptographic algorithms like SHA-256 and AES-128. It also has a high-quality random number generator. MEMS microphone. The board comes with a MEMS microphone for audio input, so external hardware isn't needed. RGB LED. There is a built-in RGB LED on the board for creative visual feedback. High-efficiency buck converter. There is a DC to DC buck converter for stepping down from VIN voltage on the board to 3.3 volts. Traditionally, older microcontroller boards used linear regulators which were inefficient. The microcontroller runs on the standard 3.3 volts internally but can run on 5 volts from USB and voltages up to 20 volts too due to the buck converter on board. This concludes the hardware description for the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect board. This board, however feature-packed it may be, has to face some competition from other boards, which have already taken a chunk of the hobbyist space. So we will weigh the Arduino Nano RP2040 against them. Advantages of using the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect. Increased processing power due to the powerful ARM Cortex M0 Plus cores, which the ESP32 lacks. Built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth capabilities due to the multi-radio module, which the Pi Pico lacks. There's a lot of onboard features like built-in IMU, microphone and cryptographic module along with an RGB LED. Disadvantages of using the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect. It's quite pricey compared to the contemporary boards like the Pi Pico and the ESP32. Lack of support. Since the board is relatively new, the popularity of this board in the internet forums is low. So if a problem arises, solutions may not be readily available. Let's look at the final verdict for the Arduino Nano RP2040 Connect board. Although the price is on the higher side, this board offers a complete package for an IoT development platform. Inexperienced hobbyists looking to work with an easier board for IoT projects can select this board without a second thought. However, experienced hobbyists who like tinkering with devices can opt for alternatives like the Pi Pico and add an external wireless module themselves. Or if the scenario allows, opt for an ESP32. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.